Ayan, so for this afternoon, we'll be doing our third machine experiment, which is about loops in C++. So as you can see here in part 1, so naglagay ako ng mga theory that could help us out para magkaroon tayo ng idea regarding looping statement in C++. And then may mga discussions dito, so common din naman sa C language or other programming languages that we are using before. We do have a lot of loop statements. So one of which is the for loop. Yan. So ito yung kanyang syntax para magkaroon po tayo ng for loop. Merong for variable initialization, and then semicolon, of course, the condition, and then the variable update, open and close curly braces, and then the code to execute while the condition is true. And then ito yung example na ipapaliwanag ko later on. And then similarly, aside from the looping statement, meron din tayong for loop rather, meron din tayong while loop. So yung structure niya while, and then whether the condition, and then again open and close curly braces, and then code to execute while the condition is true. Then another example for the while loop here. And then another type of the looping statement is the do while. So yung structure niya naman, whether the do, open and close curly braces, and then while, and then the condition enclosed by semicolon. So another example here is for the do while. And then whether the activity. So pinapakita ko ngayon sa screen yung example natin doon sa mga looping statement. So meron tayong for loop, meron tayong while loop, and then meron tayong do while. So itong ating first example, syempre gagamit ulit tayo ng preprocessor command, which is number include IO stream, and then kailangan natin yung using namespace std para makita natin yung cout and end line. So kasi nga gagamit tayo ng cout and then the end line. And then we have here the main body, open and close curly braces, and then ito na nga, gumamit na tayo ng for loop. So nakalagay dito na for int x is equal to 23, x greater than 1, and x minus minus. So yung loop po natin goes while x is greater than 1 and x increases by 1 every loop. Yan. Keep in mind that the loop condition checks the conditional assignment before it loops again. Consequently, when x equals 10, then the loop breaks. X is updated before the condition is checked. So ito, in-edit ko na yung part na to. Kaya kung makikita po natin dito sa ating example code for the for loop. Ayan. So yung given dito is int x is equal to 0. Ayan, 0 to. And then x less than 10. Ayan. So syempre, alam na natin, execute, compile, and run, or kung anong compiler yung ginagamit po natin. Yan. So makita mo, ganun yung nakita natin na output. Bakit? Kasi nakalagay dito ay x minus minus. It should be x plus plus. Then execute, compile, and run. So nakita natin, 0 to 9. Kasi nga, yung range na i-display niya is from 0, then x plus plus is just an increment plus 1. Until such time that the value of x is less than 10. So yun po yung 9. Kaya po meron tayong 0 to 9. Syempre, nakita mo example kanina, kung ang gusto mong gawin ay decrement, so gawin mo tong minus minus. And then syempre, kailangan mo rin mag-change dun sa initialization and then dun sa ating condition in between. So yun lang po yung ginagawa nung first example. Pangalawang example po natin here, ganun uli, kailangan uli natin ng preprocessor command, kailangan uli natin ng using namespace std, then whether the main function, and then this time, nag-initialize tayo, nag-declare tayo ng variable x of data type int, and then yung initial value niya ay 10. Then sabi dito, while x greater than 0, so yung x referring here to the initialized value of x, which is 10. So habang ang value daw ng 10 and ng x ay greater than 0, so gagawin niya to. And then C out, i-display niya on the screen yung value ni x and then end line. So ito namang x minus minus, syempre decrement, update x so the condition can be met eventually. Then C in that get para magstay on the screen yung ating output. So of course, we can execute, compile, and run. din yun. So, nag-start tayo with 10, and then, syempre, nag-end tayo with 1. Syempre, pwede mo siyang gawing 20. Yan. Execute, compile, and run. Yan. So, execute, compile, and run. Ayan. So, 20 to 1. Yung third example natin is, this time, doing naman to while. So, ganun ulit yung first parts. So, this time, itong ginawa naman dito, dineclare natin si x as data type int, and then yung initial value na x ay 0, then meron tayong do while here. Gagawin niya itong statement na to habang yung x ay hindi equal sa 0. So, nakalagay dito, hello world is printed at least one time even though the condition is false. So, i-display niya lang sa screen yung hello world and then i-retain niya lang yung sa screen gamit yung cin.get. So, ito makita natin, hello world. Ayan. So, balik na yung tayo dun sa ating activity. So, now that I discussed to you the examples, these are the tasks that you needed to do for this afternoon. Yung una, you have to design a program that will output your name. Kailangan ma-display yung pangalan mo on the screen 10 times. So, since by pair po kayo, pwedeng dalawang version ng code yung gawin mo or ipagsamahin mo na lang sa isang code yung ating gagawin na i-display na pangalan on the screen na 10 times. Design a program 3 times, once with each looping method. So, ibig sabihin, kailangan ko ng tatlong method. Gamit ang for loop, gamit yung while, gamit yung do while. Pangalawa, design a program that counts from 1 to 12. Output the values on a separate line for each. Ibig sabihin, every new line. And include a message of your choice when the count is 3. And a different message when the count is 8. Diba, di-display mo siya from 1 to 12. So kapag ang count mo na daw ay 3, meron siyang message na di-display on the screen. And then kapag 8 na yung count natin, ganun din. Meron din siyang i-display message on the screen. Pangatlo, design a program that counts from 1 to 100 and then outputs only those values between 32 and 39. 1 to align and then you have to use the incrementing operator for this program. Nakita natin from items 2 onwards, hindi naman kailangan na tatlong looping method yung gagamitin. Pwedeng isa lang po, pili ka lang doon. Yung number 3, hindi mo naman kailangan na i-display yung 1 to 100. Kailangan mo lang ma-display yung values 32 hanggang 39. Pero kailangan mo siyang i-loop from 1 to 100. Yung item number 4 is to design a program that counts from 1 to 10, then output the count and its square for each count. So cumulative, kailangan i-display mo yung count niya and then yung square root ng each cumulative count. Number 5, design a program that will compute the sum of 1 to 200 and then display the output. And then number 6, design a program that will compute the sum of 1 plus 1 half plus 1 third plus 1 over terms where the term is specified by the user. Ibig sabihin, you'll be asking the user to input the term. Then, yung summation po natin ng fraction will depend on the term inputted by the user. And then yung item number 7 po natin, design a program that will compute and accept 12 numbers from the user. Then you have to get the average and simply display the output. So as usual, kailangan uli natin screenshot yung code along with the simulation results. Yung ilalagay natin sa results and discussion and provide a conclusion. Yung first part natin is about program specification. Then kung gusto mo maglagay ng theory, optional po yon. And then submit po ulit natin sa classwork. Again, one member per pair yung kailangan mag-submit nating experiment number 3. Thank you.